गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, नमस्ते बच्चों, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माई सेल्फ ओम प्रकाश केसरी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू अ टॉपिक ऑन रीमान इंटीग्रल विच आर कम्स अंडर द सब्जेक्ट रियल मैथ्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स। दिस सब्जेक्ट इज टॉट इन MSc Mathematics second semester student. These are the lesson plan, and here we define the lesson plan. Now some steps for lesson plan is preparation, presentation, association, generalization, and their application. These are the components of a lesson plan in which the identifying we are identifying the data, aid material, instrumentational objects, previous knowledge tested, introduction and announcement of topic, presentation, articulation, and then finally home assignment. Today I am going to taught you the subject for MSc Mathematics second semester, which are comes from the sub science stream under mathematics, and the name of topic is real analysis. Now in real analysis we are going to start Riemann integral. And before starting the Riemann integral, we first define some basic terminology such as partition, their norms, Riemann sum, oscillatory sum, definition of partitions, etc. In this lecture, first of all, we define the term partitions in a set theory. Let AB be a closed set, bounded interval on the real line R. We assume that A is always less than equals to B. By partition, we mean P of AB. By partition P of AB, we mean a finite subset x naught, x one, x two, dot dot x n of the interval, closed interval AB, such that A equals to x naught less than x one, less than x two, less than dot dot dot, less than x n minus 1, less than x n equals to b. Then such a partition P is often denoted by P equals to under curly bracket A equals to x 1 comma x 2 comma x 3 comma dot 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 comma x n minus 1 comma x n, which is equals to b. This defines the partition. That means if we plot all these points and meet the all lines, we get a net, a structure like net. That's why this partition is also known as net. And this is taken always in a closed interval. Therefore, we can write here in general form the closed subinterval xk minus 1 comma xk, where k equals to 1 2 3 dot dot n, may be denoted by delta k, and call these cell of the partition. That means one hole of the net. That means one hole of the net. And the point xk may be called the partitioning point of P. Partitioning point of P. If norm of delta k denotes the length delta k minus 1 of delta k. If norm of delta k denotes the length xk minus 1 of delta k, the norm P may be denoted and defined by mu of p equals to max of deltas, max of deltas, that means delta mod delta 1 mod delta 2 mod dot mod delta n. Now this is the definition of partition, and I already told you that we first define the partition in their norms, Riemann sum, oscillatory sum, and definition of a partitions. Now we are moving to the Riemann sum. Riemann sums are of two types: lower Riemann sum and upper Riemann sum. Here we define Riemann sum as: let f be a bounded in real interval function whose domain is a closed bounded interval ab, where the interval ab is closed and bounded. Therefore, we can say that a must be less than equals to b. And previously we defined the partition, and we take same partition as: let p be equals to a equals to x naught comma x one comma x two comma dot 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 xn equals to b, be a partition of ab, and let delta k be an in sub interval such as delta k minus 1 comma delta k, delta k minus 1 comma delta k, which are in closed interval, where k equals to 1 2 dot 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 n. Since f is bounded in ab, it is necessary to bounded in each sub interval delta k. That means we can say that the function is bounded in whole the interval, then they are also bounded in partially sub interval. We put delta k equals to mod of delta k equals to the length xk minus xk minus 1, and let mk, capital mk and small mk, be the least upper bound and greatest lower bound of f. Here mk is capital mk and small mk be the least upper bound and greatest lower bound of f in delta k, where k is equals to 1 to the root n, and mk, capital mk and small mk will be referred to be as bound of f in delta k. Then we can define upper Riemann sum and lower Riemann sum. Now the upper Riemann sum will be noted and defined by union of f of p, f comma p is equals to sum of k equals to 1 to n mk mod delta k, and lower Riemann sum can be defined as L of f comma p equals to summation over k equals to 1 to n small mk delta k mod delta k, where small delta k, mk and capital mk are similarly known as greatest lower bound and least upper bound. That means capital mk is known as least upper bound and small mk is known as greatest lower bound of the function f. Then the function u f comma p is called the upper Riemann sum and upper Darboux sum, or simply upper sum of f, corresponding to the partition p. Similarly, L of fp is called the lower Riemann sum or lower Darboux sum, or simply lower sum of f, corresponding to the partition p. This sum defines upon the function f and the partition p. This sum defines upon the function f, and the partition p. Since f is the only function considered here, then upper bound of f on partition p and lower bound of f on partition p may be denoted in short by U of P and L of P respectively. For the sake of simplicity. For the sake of simplicity, we can denote U of FP and L of FP will be U of P and L of P respectively, because here both functions are same. Thus, the sum LP and UP exist for some bounded function. For some bounded function. Now, MK and delta K will be known as the contributions to UP, upper bound of P. That means upper Riemann sum of P, upper Riemann sum of P. That means MK and into mod delta K will denotes the upper Riemann sum from the kth cell. From the kth cell where delta K and small MK into delta mod delta K will be known as the contribution to the lower Riemann sum over P from the kth cell delta K. Now we are going to define the oscillation of F on a state. Let WK equals to MK capital MK minus small K. Then the WK is called the oscillations of F on delta K. Then the WK is said to be oscillations of F on delta K. Oscillations of F on delta K. Oscillations of F on delta K. Now, we see some definitions of real analysis. Riemann sum, upper Riemann sum, lower Riemann sum, partition, and the greatest lower bound and least upper bound of a function f. Now this session is powered by the digital version 2.0 of Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, and I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will try to solve it. Thank you. Thanks to hear. Thank you.